गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। एम आई ऑडिबल?
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
यस
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
यस गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
या
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
ओके गुड मॉर्निंग। सो आई थिंक दिस थ्योरी ऑफ द टाइप फाइव वी डिस्कस इन द लास्ट सेशन ओनली व्हाई देयर इज अ नीड ऑफ चेंज ऑफ वेरिएबल इज दैट
नो सर, फॉर डिवीजन वन यू डिड
ओके
नॉट
सर।
टीच सर।
जस्ट जस्ट
फॉर
जस्ट मिनट
डिवीजन।
जस्ट मिनट। माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल नाउ?
Yes, sir.
ओके
Yes,
ओके थैंक यू।
sir.
सो दिस टाइप फाइव थ्योरी वी डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट सेशन फॉर बोथ द डिवीजन आई थिंक।
नो सर।
नो सर।
नो सर।
नो। सो टाइप फोर एग्जांपल्स वी फिनिश इन द लास्ट सेशन। टाइप फोर।
यस सर।
ओके।
यस सर।
आई विल शो यू दैट स्लाइड अदरवाइज सो यू कैन चेक वेदर वी फिनिश दिस पार्ट। दिस इज द लास्ट एग्जाम्पल वी डन। Is that this example? Double integral r
Yes,
sin
sir.
theta dr d theta over a cardioid. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So let me see the last type now. So the last type of double integration is a change of variable. So remember there are total five types in the double integral. Type one, double integration is given. We evaluate it directly. Type 2, the region is given, so we have to, from the region we have to find the limits and then we have to evaluate. Type 3, we have to change the order. In type 4, we evaluate double integral in a polar form, and now the last type we have is a change of variable. So first let me discuss about why there is a need to change the variable. Okay, so this change of variable is a very important concept for double integration. Many of the double integrals are impossible or they are difficult to evaluate. I will repeat. Many of the double integrals are impossible or difficult to evaluate. In such a case, it's better to transform double integral from one domain to other domain and evaluate it. This problem is similar problem to our day-to-day life. Generally, I say like, or there is one example I will generally give, and that example is like, suppose some person is a sick and he is not able to cure by one particular doctor. Then he can either wait or he have another option. He should change the doctor and he can take a treatment from some other doctor and then he can find the result, because the problem does not have a solution with one person, so we generally find it with some other person. In that same way, suppose the problem does not have a solution in the given domain, we try to find the solution of the same problem in the other domain that way. Now so what is the change of variable then? The change of variable is like this. We have some double integral. I'll write one double integral here. Double integration, some function of xy dx dy over some region R. For simplicity, let I take that region R is a circle, say x square plus y square is equal to 4. So if I draw this curve, this is the circle of radius 2. Okay, so this is the circle of radius 2. So this one is the curve x square plus y square equal to 4, and suppose the region is bounded by the circle, it's given. So in such a case, this one is our region of integration. This one will be the region of integration. Now suppose this double integral f over this region is very difficult to evaluate. So generally we use a transformation. So this transformation will be always given in a question. Okay, so you should not find the transformation your own. So that will be given in a question. For example, suppose for this curve, suppose we are given a transformation, say u is equal to x square and v is equal to y square. U is x square and v is a y square. Can anyone tell me what will be the image of this circle, image of a circle in a UV plane? Right now the curve is in the XY plane. Now we have to draw its equivalent curve in a UV plane. So I will take two axes again. This is the U axis and this one is a V axis. Previously that was the X axis and the Y axis there in XY plane. Yes, what will be the image? 108. So 101.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I am asking a question. What will be the equation of a circle in a UV plane? Or 101, you can also answer. Yes, 105, 157 given the correct answer in the chat window. They are saying it should be a straight line. And that's correct. You'll observe x square is a u, y square is a v. So we got equation as, I will say, u plus v. Just a minute. This one is a u. U plus v is equal to 4. The same equation, this x square plus y square equal to 4 become u plus v equal to 4. And if you draw this straight line, now this straight line will be like this. So provided these coordinates are 0, 4 and this is a 4, 0. And it may happen, the region of integration also changed. Whatever the circular region we have, that may become the region of a triangle. Okay, so we'll see all this detail, how the, what will be the region and how it is decided in the numericals only. But I want to tell you one important thing. Right now what happens, our original region of integration, is in XY plane and that is a circle, the circular region. By the transformation u equal to x square and v equal to y square, that circular region converted to the triangle. So the two things happen, the region of integration may change. Okay, the region of integration may change. Only there is one special transformation under which the region of integration remains same. For example, for the same curve, x square plus y square equal to 4, if I use a transformation, say x equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sine theta, if we use this special transformation known as a Cartesian to the polar, this is the special transformation, Cartesian to the polar, and if you draw the curve in a polar form, say this is theta equal to 0, and now if you draw, what will be the equation of the circle in with this transformation, x equal to r cos theta and y equal to r sine theta. Yes, 102. What will be the equation of the circle x square plus y square equal to 4 with this special transformation? 102, you are not audible. 103. One zero five. Have the mic problem. 106.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I don't have a mic problem.
Sir. Okay, so last time I think you're not. Okay, so tell me the equation, but.
Sir, is it r is
equal? R is equal to 2.
R is equal to 2. Very good. Okay, so you replace x by r cos theta here, y by r sine theta. You get r square equal to 4. So r is equal to 2, and what it represents? R equal to 2.
It's a diameter, it's a circle with a diameter 2.
Not correct. It's a circle with a radius 2 and
the radius 0, 0. Radius 2, sir.
Okay. So
yes, sir.
That is also the circle of radius 2, and you will observe the region of integration is original circle is of radius 2. This is also 2, 0 and center 0, 0. This is also center 0, 0 and radius is 2. So the region remains same under Cartesian to polar transformation only. So one special transformation is there, x equal to r cos theta and y equal to r sine theta. This is only one particular transformation under which the region of integration remains same. Otherwise, all other transformation like this random transformation will change the shape of the region, So there is one more, some few other transformation also under which the region can remain same. For example, identity transformation, if you replace x by u and y by v, yes, circle remains circle only, because when you replace x by u and y by v, you get u square plus v square equal to 4. And that will be again a circle in a UV plane. But identity transformation will be never used in change of variable, because when you use identity transformation, the problem remains same. It is not simplified then. It is not simplified. So the summary is, first of all, we are given some double integral. We are given some double integral in XY domain, which is a very difficult or complicated to evaluate. And our aim is to transform this double integral and evaluate it. So for that, we are given the transformation in terms of UV, from XY to UV. So the first step that we have to do it, we have to find the region in a UV plane. Find the region in a UV plane. Once we get that region in a UV plane, we can take vertical strip or horizontal strip to get the limits of U and V. Okay, either vertical strip or horizontal strip we can take it to get the limits of UV. And only last thing is left. Everything, all this double integral, we have to convert from XY to UV with given equation of XY to UV. So this value of dx dy also we should calculate, because the dx dy will not be direct du dv. It is given by the formula, and there's one formula. Dx dy is nothing but it is a Jacobian of XY with UV du dv. So this one more formula we have to remember only for a general transformation. So what is this Jacobian now? This you are going to learn it in partial differentiation. In partial derivative, you are going to learn this formula. dx dy is a Jacobian of xy with a uv du dv. And that Jacobian is nothing but, this is Jacobian of xy with uv is a determinant of a partial derivatives. The partial derivatives of x with u, dou x by dou u, dou x by dou v. Now I will take partial derivative of y with u, and derivative of y with v. And these are partial derivative, and the meaning of partial is when we differentiate x with u, the other variable v is a constant, like that. Okay. Can anyone tell me what will happen if we interchange the rows with a column of a determinant? If we interchange the rows and column of a determinant.
Come again?
Sir, negative and positive.
It becomes
negative and positive.
When no. The value of determinant becomes negative.
No.
A minus sign comes out of the determinant.
Not correct. The property says when we interchange the rows and columns of a determinant, the value of determinant remains same. So if I write like this, dou x by dou u and dou x by dou v, and here I write dou y by dou u and dou y by dou v, then also the value of a determinant remains same. So I'm telling you the partial derivatives of x, you can write it either in the rows or in a column. So both are the same. So any one of this definition you can use it, either the first or the second, the determinant value remains same by interchanging rows with a column. Okay, when you interchange only two rows amongst each other, okay, then the value of determinant changes in a sign. So that is not done here. It is interchanging rows with a column. Okay, so value of determinant remains same. So this is a formula for Jacobian, and that is a partial differentiation. So this formula we use to get the values of a Jacobian. Here, one standard transformation is there. That is, for this, the Jacobian value, if you calculate the Jacobian value, it will coming R. I will prove it here. Let us calculate Jacobian of XY with R theta. Provided this X is R cos theta and Y is R sine theta. So the first row I want like dou x derivative of x with r, then dou x by dou theta, then dou y by dou r, and dou y by dou theta. Now let I ask 179 is there?
Yes, sir.
Tell me partial of x with r, what is the value?
So it will be so just cos theta.
Yes, very good. You are correct. Partial of x with a theta now.
So it will be r.
Not correct.
Sorry. Minus sine r.
Minus r sine theta.
theta.
Minus r sine theta.
Similarly, partial of y with r is sine theta, r cos theta. And if you expand this determinant, you will get cross multiplication r cos square theta plus r sine square theta, and r coming common, cos square plus sine square is 1. So because of that, dx dy is considered as r dr d theta, because that r is nothing but it's a Jacobian value of xy with r theta. So whenever we use the standard transformation for a problem, Cartesian to polar, then directly we have to use this. No need to prove the Jacobian. There is no need to calculate the value of Jacobian. Directly we say the value of dx dy is r dr d theta. I hope that's clear. But when the random transformation is given or general transformation given, xy to any u and v, that time we calculate this Jacobian and we take the values like this, dx dy as a Jacobian of, okay, that way. There is, now the last thing.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes. Yes, tell me.
Sir, here we are, sir, here, am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Sir, I am telling that here we are substituting the initial variables to some other variables. So correct. We can't put that dx dy into after getting the derivative of that variable which we are putting in.
No, there we
instead
can't,
of calculating Jacobian.
No, we can't, because there is a proof behind that. This is the formula, and that have the proof which gives us the small area in xy plane, which is mapping to the small area in UV plane, and you can go through the proof in the textbook there. Okay, so you can't write directly dx dy as a du dv. Okay, or you, if you know this, like x is r cos theta, and you cannot say dx is a dr cos theta, something like that. Okay, you can't do like that.
So, no, sir, I'm not telling that I am writing, I will write dx dy equal to du dv.
Okay, then
I'm telling that by replacing x with u and y with v, after taking the derivative, we can get a value of dx in terms of du and get a value of dy in terms of dv. So okay, we can't put it that.
So tell me what will be the value of a dx in terms of dr from this.
Okay, sir. Excuse me.
Is it possible?
Dx dr.
We can't. Okay. One thing, it is not like x is replaced only in terms of u. If that is the case, we can say dx is a 2u du. You can write that way. It is for single variable. That's a total differentiation. This is known as a total derivative. But here, x is replaced in two variables, and you can't say like dx is equal to like r minus r sine theta d theta plus cos theta dr, something that. That is not applicable here. Actually, there is one formula. I will tell you that. Okay.
I got my answer, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay, welcome. So the important thing you should remember, if you have a confusion for why we are not able to replace dx by direct in du dv, okay, or dy in du dv, you can go through this formula, then you come to know that you can't do that. Okay, so that is one thing. So this formula, we use it for general transformation, but when the boundary is a circle, we prefer this transformation, Cartesian to polar. And when the boundary is ellipse, there is again a special transformation of ellipse, and this we use because when we use x equal to ar cos theta and y equal to br sin theta, these are not the standard polar transformation. These are special transformation made for ellipse. Okay, and what they do here, when you replace x by ar cos theta here and y by br sin theta, this equation of ellipse, that a square gets cancelled here, b square gets cancelled, and you get r is equal to 1. What happened? The shape of the ellipse is deformed to the circle. So any ellipse will map to the circle of radius 1 by using this special transformation. This is the special transformation for the ellipse. X equal to ar cos theta, y equal to br sin theta, and then dx dy is abr dr d theta. This abr is a value of a Jacobian. I'll repeat, the abr is a value of Jacobian. We are going to learn about these two things in the next session in detail for a circle and ellipse. Right now, today, we'll focus only one example on general transformation from xy to uv plane. Okay, this is from xy to uv plane. Okay, so can I move to the example then?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So the question, let I show you this example. Now you can note down the question if you want. Using the transformation x plus y equal to u, y equal to uv, evaluate this double integral. Integration is taken over the triangular region bounded by x0, y0, x plus y equal to 1. Now the first and most important thing, in the question, the transformation is always provided. So that is given. Okay. Whenever the transformation is provided, the meaning of that is whatever the double integral we are given, it may be difficult to evaluate. It may be difficult to evaluate. So right now, yes, it is difficult to evaluate. You can't integrate it directly. Okay. This transformation will help us to integrate it. The cost behind is that we require some calculations, like we have to find the value of a dx dy. We have to find out the image of this triangle of xy plane in a uv plane, what it represents. That's the second thing. Okay, so all that things we have to find it here one by one. So let we go step by step. So first thing, let we find the value of a dx dy. So 171, 171, 158.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What is the value of dx dy formula? Tell me. Well, first of all, let we write a transformation, whatever given. So I want x and y in u and v only. So what is the value of x and y in u, v? 158. Value of y is directly given. What is that?
U, v.
Y is u, v. And what is x in terms of u, v now?
X in terms of u, v. U1 minus v.
U minus u, v. Okay. So first step, we should write a transformation. And what is a transformation? X is a function of uv and y should be function of uv, that way. So that we can write every equation of xy in terms of uv later on, like this, all these. So before we start that double integral, first we'll find the value of a dx dy. Now dx dy is a Jacobian of xy with a uv du dv. So this is a formula. Therefore, the value of the Jacobian becomes, it's a determinant now. Now I will ask 130, 130. Tell me a formula for this Jacobian. 130, quick. 133, yes. 133,
165.
Yes, anyone?
Sir,
tell me.
Sir, dx by
dou x by dou u.
Partial derivative.
Yes, sir.
Dou x by dou v. Or you say partial of x with v, like that.
The partial of y upon partial of u.
Okay.
And partial of y upon partial of v.
Very good. That's one. Now tell me the derivatives also now. What is the dou x by dou u?
So one minus v.
1 minus v, correct. Dou x by dou v.
So zero minus u. That is minus
u. Minus u.
Minus u, sir.
Dou y by dou u.
V and u.
Okay. V and then. So let we expand this determinant now. Cross multiply. This you will get u into 1 minus v plus uv. Is that? And if you simplify, it become u minus uv plus uv. So at the end, this uv uv gets cancelled. And what we get here, we got dx dy. The Jacobian value we get as a u du dv. So this is a step number one that we should find. So those who are interested, write down this part so that I will move to the next then. So just we calculated the value of dx dy here. If anyone have a doubt, yes, you can ask. Yes, 134.
Good morning, sir.
Yes, good morning.
So when you were explaining this Jacobian, you said that in terms of r and theta, you said only r will come as a Jacobian value. Yes. So is it necessary to solve all the determinants, or we can write just here in place of r we have u? So we can write a u.
No, not correct. So you are just generalizing from two results. Okay, it is not true for every transformation. For different transformation, you get a different value of a Jacobian. Okay.
Okay,
only, only for that xy to r theta you have to remember, that is direct r, not for all other, or all other it can be a different. Here it came by chance similar to that. Okay, okay, good observation, but you can't generalize it. Yes, any other doubt? So step one, what we completed, just we calculated dx dy. Now, step two, we have to find the image of the region, or image of the boundaries of XY region, so that we can plot the region in UV plane. So can I start the step two?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I will erase this part now. So in the step two now, we have to find the image of each boundary. There are three boundaries, 1, 2, and 3. Let me start x equal to 0. What is x equal to 0?
V equals to 1.
Y axis.
Not correct. Y-axis. I am not asking it in okay, xy plane. I am asking what is the image of x equal to 0 in a UV plane.
So V equals to 1?
Not only V equal to 1. So when x is a 0, you can say u minus uv is a 0. Okay. So u minus uv is a 0 means u into 1 minus v is a 0. Sorry, 1 minus v is a 0. So I will say u is a 0 and v is a 1. So we are getting two lines. I hope this is clear. So x equal to 0, x equal to 0 represent the line u equal to 0 and v equal to 1. Okay. Y equal to 0 now?
U 0, V 0.
Correct. So U, Y equal to 0 means UV is a 0, means U 0 and V 0. So actually image is repeating here, but yes, this also gives us the two lines there. And what is X plus Y equal to 1?
U equals to 1.
Very good. U is equal to 1. Any doubt in getting these images? What we done, we have three lines. For each of the line, we have got these images there. Now, we have to draw the region in a UV plane. So, to draw the region in a UV plane, let I take some U axis and some V axis here. Now, I will ask (115, 115, 145)
Yes, sir.
What is the u equal to 0?
What is u equal to 0? Sir, v.
V axis. Okay, very good.
Yes, sir.
So u equal to 0 is a v axis. So the first line we got as a u equal to 0. Now, what is a u equal to 1?
U equal to 1. So parallel line.
V axis.
Around v. Yes, sir.
Very good. So v equal to 0.
V equal to 0. So, parallel line to the U.
No. V equal to 0 is itself U.
Oh, V equals to 0. Oh, sir, yes, sir. U.
Okay, I so V equal to 0. And V equal to 1 parallel to?
Oh, that is parallel.
Yes. This is V equal to 1. So, what is the region of integration then?
Region.
Square. Square there. Okay. So, See the step 1. Step 1, we calculated this value of a dx dy. Step 2, we calculated the region of integration. Now, last step, our aim is to integrate this double integral in a UV domain. Okay, now the last step is left. I hope all of you written all these things. If you completed, tell me so that I can move to the last step, step number 3.
Sir?
Yes.
So, can you please explain how it comes u is equal to 1 in x plus y is equal to 1?
Tell me, what is the value of x?
the zero.
X or value u, is a u minus
u, minus u v.
And value of y is u v. Take addition. X plus y become u, na?
Got it.
Any other doubt, anyone? Can I move to the last step, step 3 then? If you've done it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So again, I will erase this small part here. So the last step is left here. That is the integral. Therefore, integral value will become, it's a double integral. Now, we don't have to write this integral in x and y. So, none of the term should be in x and y. Everything we have to write in u and v. So, 135 is there? No, 125. Okay, 135, yes. 135. What is the value of y minus x? What is the value of y minus x in terms of uv?
Uv minus... Just u, sir.
So...
The 2 uv minus...
125.
So 2 uv minus u by u.
Okay, yes.
165.
It's a 165. 2 uv.
Minus u upon
minus u. And already we seen y plus x or x plus y is a
upon u.
And value of dx dy is a u du dv. So this is the way we transform the double integral from xy to uv. Now, whatever this entire double integral that we have in xy domain, it is a transform completely in a uv domain. It is transformed in a other domain, and hoping the calculation becomes a simple, because the purpose of a transformation is to simplify the problem. Okay, so on the limits we require here. So what will be the limits for this double integral? 116. What will be the limits for the double integral? 127.
So 0 to 1.
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. 0 to 1 0 to 1. You'll observe clearly the u is also varying from 0 to 1 and v is also varying from 0 to 1. You can take any of the strip, vertical or horizontal. So it doesn't matter if your strip will be like this. So this will be u equal to 0, u equal to 1 and v equal to 0 to 1. So both are 0 to 1. Limits are constant. So it's a square. Yeah.
So in that dx dy equals to u du dv, that u is permanent or that will vary according to the question?
So that we discuss only in the beginning. Someone asked me, can I generalize? Because I said dx dy is r dr d theta, and here you got dx dy is u du dv. So it is just a first variable. It's not like that. It changes according to a transformation. If transformation is a different, say, if my transformation is x equal to u square and y equal to v square, your value of dx dy will change here. Okay, this value will change. Got it?
Okay, sir, got it.
Okay. So, that about...
Sir, we will take another example.
Pardon?
Sir, we will take another example of this kind of... Sir.
Actually, there are only two to three examples are there only. This is only the example that asked number of times. Yes, there are two more examples on this, so we'll do that, and that time you'll come to know. But one of that example will never, that never ask, we'll go through that also, okay, after this. Okay, so last step is left, that is integration here. So what happens in the integrand there, first thing?
Sir, can you cut u from numerator and denominator, so it will become...
So that is only the first simplification. We get only 2v minus 1, e raised to 2v minus 1, u du dv.
Yes, sir.
Now integration. So if anyone want to answer, raise your hand. Yes, 149.
Yes, sir.
Tell me the integration now.
So e 2v minus 1 will be constant.
Okay.
And your u integration of u du will be u 2 upon 2. U square upon 2.
So u square upon 2 and the limits is a 0 to 1.
Yes. Finally, the answer.
Okay. So this is 1 by 2. That is out.
Yes, sir.
What about the next integration? E raised to 2v minus 1.
So it will be e raised to 2v minus 1 upon 2.
Yes, correct. Very good.
0 to 1.
0 to 1. Now replace upper and lower limit.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, as the limits are constant, so can we take u constant first, sir, and then
yes,
v
you
constant?
Yes, you can. When all limits are constant, you can integrate with any variable first. Okay.
Okay,
when limits,
sir,
are constant, or you can integrate both.
But in the beginning of double integration, you taught us the jiska bhi variable pehle likha hota, we have to integrate that term first. So agar if
correct,
it is written that du it's first, so we have to integrate du first, right? We cannot take du constant.
Yes, that is main important thing. When du is a first, you should integrate first with respect to u. Now, but when the limits, all limits are constant, in that case, you can change the order also directly. Like instead of du, dv, you can write dv, du, and you can interchange their limits also and integrate. Or when limits are constant and this is a function of v into function of u is there, you can integrate both these things at the same time also, that is simultaneously. So if you don't want to confuse, I will tell you, just follow the order. Okay. And jinko other ways ki bhi interest hai, those are thinking that what are the other ways to do this. So there are multiple ways. You can change the order. You can do the integration simultaneously. Okay. All that things are there. Clear? The best way is follow the order, because what is the case? If suppose inner limits are variable, in that case, compulsory you have to follow the order. There is no option. But when limits are constant, the option starts there. Okay. So in this case, all limits are constant. And yes, you can integrate first with v, then u. Or you can do both integration at the same time because it is separate again functions, so that the options are there. And your answer will be unique at any case, 1 by 4 e minus 1 by e.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, I have a doubt regarding dxdy equals to du dv.
Ask me.
Sir, can you just explain how this that u came?
We calculated na beginning Jacobian value. Jacobian of xy with uv. Is that?
Okay, sir.
So u will come because of that Jacobian value. Jacobian of xy with uv. And that is a u in this case. And u that value
sir,
will not always u.
So we have substituted that from Jacobian value, that is u is equal to b.
Correct.
Got it, sir.
Okay.
Sir, excuse me. Sir, will you please show the explanation of Jacobian value? Or did you take off? No, sir. My connection was completely unstable. I'm
so this is the problem. Actually, if your disconnection is there, now can I? Okay, I have time. Okay, so right now it's okay, but it's not always.
Sir, I am taking this view. Can I share?
Whether all of you completed this? All of you completed this? Can I show you again a Jacobian then?
Yes, sir.
So let I move to the Jacobian again back, because you are not alert while we calculated Jacobian. It's not so difficult. It's a very simple case actually. These are partial derivatives only. So the general formula for dx dy is a Jacobian of xy with a uv du dv. This is the formula that we have. Because of this formula, we calculate Jacobian. So Jacobian J is a determinant. Yes, who lost the connection? Yes, who lost the connection that time? Who is asking? Formula for Jacobian.
It's dx du, dx by du.
Okay.
फिर dy by du dv.
You can write it in rows or column, okay?
Yes.
Now tell me this dou x by dou u. Here is the relations.
Yes, sir. It is 1 minus z.
What is the dou x by dou v?
Dou x by dou v will be 0 minus u.
Dou y by dou u?
It will be only v. Yes, sir.
Now evaluate this determinant, you will get the answer as a u.
Okay, sir.
Is there any doubt, anyone?
Sir,